फंडामेंटल पार्टिकल्स ऑफ एन एटम। गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट दी फंडामेंटल पार्टिकल्स ऑफ एन एटम। सो बिफोर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट दी फंडामेंटल पार्टिकल्स ऑफ एन एटम, सो व्हाट इज द एटम? Atom means the substance or material is made up of the small tiny particles. The tiny particles are called the atom. So in 1909, John Dalton proposed the indivisible tiny particles of matter is called the atom. But after the proposed by the Dalton, after Dalton atom, some scientists experimented on the atomic structure, like J.J. Thomson, Rutherford, Goldstein, William Crookes, and Niels Bohr. They conducted the experiment on the electrical conductance of gases. So based on this experiment, electrical conductance of gas at low pressures means they will take some gas in a vacuum tube and conduct the electricity on the gas at low pressures. They observed that the Dalton atom is again, so Dalton atom is again is made up of some particles. The Dalton atom is divisible, is made up of some particles. So they call the positive particles and negative particles and neutral particles. These particles are called the fundamental particles of an atom. Fundamental particles of an atom. So we'll discuss about the fundamental particles of an atom. What are the fundamental particles? Means the Dalton atom is not divisible. Dalton proposed the atom is indivisible, but based on the scientist experiment, the Dalton is again divisible and is made up of some particles. That particles are called the fundamental particles of an atom. The fundamental particles are the electron. First one is the electron. Second one is the proton. And third one is the neutron. Let us discuss about the one by one fundamental particles. The first one is the electron. Electron proposed by the Electron discovered by the J.J. Thomson. So in cathode rays tube experiment means J.J. Thomson in 1911 so conduct the experiment, that is cathode tube experiment means he taken the some gas in a vacuum tube between the two electrodes and electricity is passed between the two electrodes. The negative rays or cathode rays are released from the cathode, that's why they are called the cathode rays. These have the negatively charged. So the name was discovered by J.J. Thomson, but name is given by Goldstein scientist. name is discovered by Goldstein scientist. So again, what is the mass of the electron? Mass of electron means, mass of electron is 9.11 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kilograms. Mass of electron is 9.11 into 10 to the power of 31 kilograms. This is taken in the kilograms. But if you take in the atomic mass unit, the mass of electron is 0.00546 atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit. Atomic mass unit. Next, the electron also has the mass. Electron has also the mass and also charge. The charge of electron is discovered by Millikan. Millikan, he is a scientist. He proposed the oil drop experiment. Oil drop experiment. In this experiment, Millikan proposed the charge of electron. That means electron has the negatively charged particle, and it has the some charge. That charge is 1.602 into 10 to the power of 19 coulombs. The electron has the negatively charged. That's why we will put the negative sign. That means it's not minus 1.602 into 10 to the power of 19 coulombs. Minus here is the electron has a negatively charged particle. If it is tell in electrostatic units, minus 4.8 into 10 to the power of minus 10 electrostatic units. Minus 4.8 into 10 to the power of minus 10 electrostatic unit. Okay. So, electron has the mass and also charge also, and also it has the some specific charge. Specific charge means the charge having charge, how much charge is present, a particular amount of mass of electron. For example, for kg of electron, how much charge is present. So the specific charge is 1.76 into 10 to the power of 11 kilograms per coulomb. That means for 1 kg of electrons, how much charge is present? 1.76 into 10 to the power of 11 kilograms. The mass of electron is very, very low. That is 9.11 into 10 to the power of minus 31 kilograms, or 0.00546 atomic mass unit. Next, let us discuss about the proton. Next one is the proton. Second one is the proton. So, proton was discovered by E. Goldstein. It has the positively charged particle. Okay, it is discovered by Goldstein in anode rays tube experiment. In anode rays tube experiment means he taken the some gas. Some gas in a vacuum tube and placed in between the two electrodes. When the electricity is positive between the two electrodes, the positive rays or anode rays are released from the anode. That's why they are called the anode rays. They have the positively charged particles. So proton has also having the mass and also charge. What is the mass of proton?
proton. So the proton mass is 1.672 into 10 to 4 of minus 27 kilograms. Or if you take the atomic mass unit, 1.00728 atomic mass unit. It is also having the charge. So charge, it has the positively charge. It is equal to the charge of electron, but it has the positive charge. What is the charge of electron? 1.60 into 10 to the power of 19 coulombs. It having the positive charge particle. That's why we will take in the positive charge. If we take the an electrostatic unit, so already we will discuss about the what is the electrostatic unit of electron. 4.8 into 10 to the power of minus 10 electrostatic unit. It is having the positive charge. That's why we will put the positive sign. It is having the some specific charge, because it is having the mass and charge. That's why it is having the specific charge. So what is the specific charge of proton means? 9.58 into 10 to the power of 7 coulombs per kilograms. What is the why the difference between the proton specific charge and electron specific charge mean? Specific charge means E by M ratio, means E for charge, M for mass. What is the charge for the particular mass? So proton mass is very heavier than the electron mass. That's why the specific charge is varies for the protons and electrons. So proton electron mass is very negligible when compared to the proton mass. Okay, next coming to the third fundamental particle is neutron. So neutron was discovered by James Chadwick. On the experiment of the bombardment of the beryllium. Beryllium with alpha particles. Alpha particle means helium particle. When the beryllium atom collision with the alpha particle, from the bombardment experiment, the neutral particles are released. The neutral particles are called the neutron. So it has also mass. So it approximately, the mass of neutron is approximately equal to the proton, but slightly greater than the proton. That is 1.675 into 10 to the power of minus 27 kilograms. Or if you tell in atomic mass unit, 1.00866 atomic mass unit. It has also mass in kilograms and atomic mass unit, but it is no charge. It is neutral in nature. That's why it has no charge and no specific charge. That's why the neutron charge is zero. That's why, because it is neutral in state. Okay, when the neutron is the neutron is the heaviest particle. That's why it is unstable. Heaviest means it is higher mass than the proton and electron. So it is unstable. That's why it is disintegrated into proton, electron, proton plus electron and neutrino. Means when the transformation of the neutron into the proton. When the neutron is released, the proton and electron and neutron, it is disintegrated into the these three particles. These about the fundamental particles of matter. Now compare with the proton and electron neutron mass. So first one which is the electron and the proton and the neutron, these three fundamental particles. So this is mass, is mass of electron is 0.00546 atomic mass unit. Proton mass which is 0.00728. Neutron mass is 1.008666. So the electron mass, when the electron mass compared to the proton and neutron, it is very very less. That is, it is 1/1836th part of proton mass. Means if the proton mass is 1, in that it is electron mass having the 1/1836th part. That's why it is, the mass of electron is very very less and is negligible when we calculate the atomic mass. So in atomic mass we will take the only proton and neutron mass. The proton and neutron mass similarly equal, but slightly the neutron mass is heavier. So relatively the proton mass is taken 1 unit and the neutron mass is taken in 1 unit, but the electron mass is very very less. That means it has the 1/1836th part of proton. That means in proton mass it has the 1/1836th part only. That's why the electron mass is negligible. And the charge of proton and charge of neutron is equal. Charge of proton and charge of neutron is equal. That is, charge of electron is 1.60 into 10 to the power of 19 coulombs. It has the negatively charge. That much positive charge is possessed by the proton. That is 1.60 into 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. It has the positive charge. Both are taken in the coulombs. So this is about the fundamental particles of an atom. For first year polytechnic student, you should remember that who discovered the electron, who discovered the proton and neutron, what is the mass of electron, proton and neutron, relatively what is the charge of proton, electron and proton.